Thank God. Today, fortunately, I got a chance to visit Varnangaram on the occasion of the feast of San Alfonso. It was my deep desire to visit the Varnangaram on the feast day, since I had an intimate devotion to her from my childhood onwards. Dear friends, I invite you to watch and see this video of the feast celebrations of San Alfonso at Varnangaram and get more graces and blessings from the Lord through the intercession of San Alfonso. As I approached the church of San Alfonso, I could see pilgrims from different parts of the country had gathered, united by their faith and love for San Alfonso. The atmosphere was filled with the faithful, with a sense of joy, devotion, and celebration. As I walked along the way to the church, I reflected on the significance of this feast. San Alfonso's life was one of immense suffering, but through it all, she found solace and strength in her deep union with Christ. We all know that San Alfonso, born as Annakutti on August 19, 1910 in Kudamalur, Kerala, India, lived in a humble and devout Christian family. From a young age, she had a profound love for God and a desire to dedicate her life to Him. However, her life was not without challenges, as she faced poverty, illness, and the early loss of her mother. Despite facing opposition from her family, Annakutti felt a deep calling to consecrate her life to God through religious life. She joined the Franciscan Clarist congregation and took the name Sister Alfonso of the Immaculate Conception. Her life in the convent was marked by severe illness and suffering, which she embraced with unwavering faith and trust in God's plan. God's call may lead us through difficult paths, but if we persevere in faith, He will grant us the strength to endure and grow. We all know very well that San Alfonso's physical ailments became a means for her to unite her sufferings with those of Christ on the cross. She offered her pain as a sacrifice for the salvation of souls, finding solace in the knowledge that her suffering had a higher purpose. Suffering can be transformed into a source of grace and an offering to God. Through our trials, we can draw closer to Christ and become instruments of His love and mercy. Throughout her life, San Alfonso also had a profound union with Christ through prayer and contemplation. Her deep love for the Eucharist and her devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary were central pillars of her spiritual life. This union with Christ enabled her to find joy and peace amidst her sufferings. Yes, it is true that intimacy with Christ in prayer and the Eucharist is vital for our spiritual growth. It strengthens us to face life's challenges and helps us find true joy in God's presence. The gathering of people at the tomb of San Alfonso in Fernignano is a testament to the profound impact she continues to have on the lives of countless individuals. Over the years, numerous miracles and blessings have been attributed to her intercession, drawing people from far and wide to seek her help and offer their prayers of gratitude. One of the most common miracles attributed to San Alfonso is healing from various physical ailments and illnesses. Many people have reported experiencing miraculous recoveries from diseases and injuries after praying at her tomb. Devotees have also witnessed remarkable financial and family blessings after praying to San Alfonso. These miracles have inspired others to turn to her for help in their own life challenges. Many individuals have sought San Alfonso's guidance and intercession in matters related to their vocations and careers. They believe that she, being a model of selfless dedication to God, can assist in discerning their life's purpose and directions. Devotees have attributed their safety and protection from natural disasters, accidents, and life-threatening situations to the intercession of San Alfonso. Couples struggling with infertility have shared stories of conceiving and bearing children after praying for San Alfonso's intercession. Her reputation as a patron of family life has drawn numerous hopeful parents to seek her help in building their families. Countless testimonies speak of individuals experiencing a profound conversion of heart and a deepening of faith after seeking San Alfonso's intercession. Her example of holiness and her love for God have touched the hearts of many, leading them to embrace a more vibrant and these miracles and many others have kindled a strong devotion to San Alfonso and inspired people to visit her tomb in Fernignano. Yes, the gathering of people at the tomb of San Alfonso is a powerful expression of faith and hope. It reflects the enduring impact of a saint whose life was marked by suffering and sacrifice, but also by an unwavering trust in God's providence. Yes, dear friends, as I bid farewell to Fernignano, I carried with me a renewed sense of faith and hope. Like St. Alfonso, may we find the strength to embrace life's challenges with unwavering faith and a heart full of love for God and our fellow human beings. May her intercession strengthen us to live lives of holiness, love and service, always seeking God's will and placing our trust in His infinite mercy. Saint Alphonsa, pray for us, that we too may become witnesses of Christ's love and grace in our lives. May God bless you all.